Hey everybody, Dr. Shaikh here from The Dentalist. It feels really good to be back after a long break, trust me. I would like to thank you all for your patience, by the way, and also for your support on the channel throughout this time. Your comments and requests for making more dental educational videos has encouraged us to start this journey all over again with more exciting learning experiences for you this time. So let's continue where we left from. Currently, we are on chapter 2, which is the properties used to characterize dental materials. In the last video, we went through modulus of elasticity, ductility, malleability, resilience, and toughness. I have attached a link to the last video so you can go back and revise if you want to. And today, we're going to talk about fracture toughness and impact strength. Now, do you remember what toughness is? Toughness is the total amount of energy that a material can absorb up to its fracture point. This means that a material is called tough if it can absorb greater amount of energy or if it can resist fracture for long. Now, the concept of fracture toughness is kind of related to the brittleness of a material. When a material is brittle, it fractures sooner, which means it doesn't have the strength to bear the stress being put on the body. A factor that could make a material weaker is crack propagation at the end of the material when the load is applied. If a material is put under load and cracks are generated, it would fracture very soon. And if we compare it with a material that can resist crack formation under load, that would make a tough material. I hope that's clear now. So basically, fracture toughness is the resistance of a material to fight back the propagation of cracks or to resist the propagation of cracks. If a material has higher fracture toughness value, this means it has the capability of avoiding crack propagation and eventually will have more resistance to fracture. And thus, it would be called as a tough material. On the other hand, if a material put under load starts generating cracks, would lose its strength too soon and will fracture pretty easily. Now, mostly brittle materials are checked for their fracture toughness so they can be handled accordingly. Toughness of a material and crack propagation also have some clinical implications. At a clinic, material could have crack propagation and lose its toughness value due to impurities or unwanted temperature and sunlight exposures, or even improper manipulation while mixing, or also due to a material's standard physical properties. Now let's talk about impact strength. I hope fracture toughness is clear to you now and you would like to move on further. Let's talk about impact strength now. It is a property which is related to the speed of stress applied. So if a stress on a body is applied slowly, then plastic deformation may occur first before it reaches to the fracture point. But on the other hand, if stress on the same body is applied rapidly, it might not undergo plastic deformation and could fracture right away. So the resistance of a material to fracture under sudden or quick load is a matter of impact strength. For example, a material would be said to have greater impact strength if it can absorb greater energy when undergone sudden blow or rapid load. But a material with lesser impact strength would fracture right after the application of a sudden load. One of the examples of impact strength in a clinical setting is when we talk about the impact strength and quality of dentures or crowns. For example, if a denture suddenly falls on the floor and breaks, it would have what? A higher impact strength or a lesser impact strength? It would definitely have a lesser impact strength, right? Because it couldn't resist the sudden blow or sudden stress that was put on the body. So if a denture is of good quality, it should have a higher number of impact strength. Impact strength is tested by a device called Charpy Impact Tester, which has a swinging pendulum as an impact tester So the position reached by the pendulum on fracturing the specimen gives a measure of the energy absorbed during fracture. Now the measurement that we get from the impact tester also contains the influence of certain factors like air resistance, since the pendulum is swinging in the air, and also friction. So therefore, a dummy run of this device is first done before putting a specimen for testing so that accurate readings can be obtained through the test. Okay? And then the specimen is tested in two ways. First, without any cracks or notches, and secondly, by intentionally introducing cracks or notches. If the material fractures quickly after introducing notches or cracks, it is termed as a notch sensitive material. So notch sensitive material would be a material which fractures too soon after intentionally creating notches or cracks during a test. Okay, I think we should end this video here, and if you want to go back and revise what we learned today, you can simply replay this video and learn from it as many times as you want. I have tried my best to make all of these concepts easy for you to understand. Still, if you have any questions or confusions, please feel free to write them down in the comment section below. And yes, I have also put a short quiz for you guys in the description, and I would love to see your answers to the question in the comment section below. Just write down the question number and the correct option. I will personally give you feedback on your answers. Also, don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends if you found it helpful. And if you still haven't subscribed, make sure you hit that subscribe button with the bell on so you can stay connected with me. See you next week, where we'll talk about the fatigue properties found in dental materials. This is Dr. Shaikh saying goodbye to you. Take care till we meet again.